Availability is super important to businesses. Why? 99% of availability sounds like a lot, but putting it into numbers, this means a device or equipment of you is not available for 4 days in a year. Still doesn't sound like much? Just imagine your boss being unable to receive emails on 4 days out of the year because your Exchange server is not available. Suddenly became an important matter, huh? So in this video, I'll show you how to monitor availability with PRTG. Of course, to do so, you'll need to have a PRTG installation up and running. If you haven't done this yet, we have a video down here for you where I'll guide you through the process and show you some important steps. If you already have your installation up and running, let's start with monitoring availability with PRTG. Now that we're done downloading and installing PRTG and our auto discovery is done running, let's start with device availability monitoring. So one of the most useful sensors to do this is our ping sensor. So first let's go to the device tree. I'm gonna do this on our core probe device because you can add the ping sensor on basically any device. So let's say add sensor. Now we see the ping sensor is the first sensor appearing. You can also see it's a very low impact ping sensor, so you almost can use as many of them as you want. So let's start adding the sensor. There's some basic seconds, for example, ping timeout, packet size, ping delay, but let's leave this all with default and just create the sensor. So if we scroll down now, we see the sensor is still in gray state, which just means he hasn't pulled any data yet. Let's scan now. And our ping sensor has its data. You can see it does not only give you the ping time, it will also show you the maximum and minimum ping time and the packet loss. Of course, there's other sensors you can use. Ping is usually associated with hardware, but of course you can also use it for cloud devices. Another very useful sensor I want to show you is the HTTP cloud. So we'll start again by adding the sensor. We go search for our HTTP cloud sensor. There it is. Again, you can see it's a very low impact sensor. Let's add it. You can see some more settings. What I'll enter here, I'm going to ping Google. I'll create the sensor. Let's refresh again to get our sensor data. And you can already see it looks a little different than our ping sensor. And here we go. So let me share a little bit what you can see here. You can see different locations around the globe. We have a probe in the west of the US, in the east of the US, in Ireland and in Japan. And it will give you the ping times to the respective locations. So this is also very useful. There's a couple of other sensors that you can use to monitor. For example, we also have the cloud ping sensor, which is similar to our cloud HTTP sensor. We have sensors to check if your SNMTP and POP3 is available. There's a couple of other sensors I want to show you. Let's just go to sensors by type, SNMP, system uptime. Here it is. Let's just choose one of them. And you can see here, for example, it just tells you your system's been running for 17 days. Of course, you can also set errors on this if your system shouldn't be running. You can create sensor factory sensors to accumulate the time it's been not running. And also, I would like to point out our PRTG script world. If you search here for uptime, first of all, of course, you get our native sensors. You get a Paessler script for nimble storage. And you also get third-party scripts. While these are third-party scripts, they've been revised by us but are not officially supported. However, you'll find useful scripts for monitoring uptime, such as the sensor uptime extractor or the uptime SLA sensors. Did I get you hooked on PRTG yet? PRTG is, of course, your all-in-one monitoring solution. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us at support@paessler.com. Or if there's any other topic you want us to make a video about, please drop us a comment below. And of course, download your trial now.